save thee, O God, for the Son of thy love. For Jesus, who died and is now born above. Hallelujah, by the glory. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, by the glory.
Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, had carried away captives
Jeconiah, the son of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, and the princes of Judah, and the carpenters and smiths from Jerusalem, and had brought them to Babylon. Now, here they had been captured and had been taken to Babylon. And the reason why they had been taken to Babylon was because the smiths and these people were known to build. They were known to build. They had a good work in building. Carpenters, they build, and smiths, and they learn how to do all kind of things like with swords and different things that they need to survive. And the Lord put this before the people because he knew what they were going to need after he finished doing what he was going to do. Come on, verse 2.
One basket had very good figs.
Come on.
Even like the figs that are fresh ripe.
Mm-hmm.
And the other basket had very knotty figs.
Come on.
Which could not be eaten. They were so bad.
Uh-huh. The first basket had very good figs. Just like the first ripe figs. The Bible says, and the other basket had very naughty figs, which could not be eaten. They were bad. So bad. Hallelujah. Okay, come on.
Then said the Lord unto me, what saidest thou? Seest thou, Jeremiah? And I said, figs, the good figs, very good, and the evil, very evil, that cannot be eaten, they are so evil.
Come on.
Again, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, like these good figs, so will I acknowledge them that are carried away captives of Judah, whom I have sent out of this place into the land of the Chaldeans for their good.
Hallelujah. As we see, the Lord has chosen to take them out and take them to Babylon for their good. He chose them to take them out for their good because there's some things God was going to do in Jerusalem and in Judea. And the same way now God saved us out of our singing so that his wrath will pass over us. But if we decide that, well, I'm just not going to do that. If we decide that we're not going to do what God said do, then the wrath will come. So the word of God let us know that he despised these people. He put them in Babylon for a reason. Come on.
Amen.
6 verse. For I will set mine eyes upon them for good.
For good.
And I will bring them again to this land. And I will build them.
Yes.
And not pull them down. And I will plant them and not pluck them up.
Come on.
And I will give them a heart to know me that I am the Lord. And they shall be my people, and I will be their God, and they shall return unto me with their whole heart.
We have a chance to return to God with our whole heart. Many of us have been in holiness for a long time. We know the word say. We know how to walk right. We know how to talk right. We know what the word tells us to do. And if we start practicing the word and put the word in practice, God will reward us. But if we don't, then we got to suffer the consequences.
Amen.
According to the word of God, he said, now he can step very deep, folk, for good.
Amen.
They wasn't so good, but you know, God saw their heart. And he saw that they wanted to do that was right in his sight. So he separated himself from people that would do what he said. And then he said, now what I'm going to do for them that went held captive, I'm going to bring them back to this land.
Thank you, Lord.
And I'm going to build them. That's why he had to send men with him. when he sent them over there into Babylon. Because all them bad things over yonder in Jerusalem and in Egypt, he said he finna get ready to pluck us. So that's why it beholds us when the word of God comes forth. We got to grab it. We got to grab this word.
Amen.
And we got to hide this word within us so we won't sin against the Almighty. Because when that day comes, you can't escape. When the day comes, when the wrath of God is poured out upon the people, we ain't gonna escape. Because just like my auntie said, she said, if I hadn't come out of that mess, God wouldn't be able to deal with me. He couldn't use me in no mess. So,
right.
It's the same with all of us in here.
Have to be clean.
He's not going to be able to use us in mess.
No, can't remain the same.
We got to come out.
Yes.
Give up to God.
Yes.
Come on, verse 7.
And I will give them a heart to know me, that I am the Lord, and they shall be my people. And I will be their God, but they shall return unto me with their whole heart.
With their whole heart. Your whole heart. That means heart from my heart, but my mind can't be on the street. Half of my heart and my mind can't be on a woman.
Oh no.
Half of my mind and my heart can't focus on something else. It got to be steadfast and unmovable on the word of God. On the things of God. He said, you being risen with Christ, seek those things which are above and not those things on the earth. So if we risen with Christ, we need to be looking for something to do in Jesus. We need to be looking for something to do in the church. Find something to do to help out. Hallelujah, Jesus. Yes, God. Because we're working out our soul salvation.
Yeah.
And we should be doing that with fear and trembling, knowing that he is going to come back ready to pay every man according to their work. Hallelujah. Come on. Verse 8.
And as the evil things which cannot be eaten, they are so evil, should be, thus says the Lord, so will I give Zedekiah, the king of Judah, and his princes, and the residue of Jerusalem that remain in this land, and them that dwell in the land of Egypt.
Come on.
And I will deliver them to be removed into all the kingdoms of the earth, for their hurt to be a reproach. And a proverb, a sonnet, and a curse in all places where I shall drive them.
So now he done sent them somewhere where they hurt. He said, I'm going to make them a reproach and a proverb, a thing of a bone. When they look around, they're going to say, that used to be people that was worshiping God, used to be folks that knew God, but they done turned their back on God, and look what done happened. You're going to be a proverb. You're going to be something old now. That's where they used to be. But now they let the devil come in and done took the joy. They done let the devil come in and fool them. Like the things in this world was more valuable than God. I have not seen in my life so many people that was in holiness and knew about holiness and knew what God was real.
Yes.
And now they want to all shake eyebrows and put all kind of mess on and just kind of foolishness.
Yes.
Old people at that too.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Shout beside us.
All right.
Some came to some of those young folks and told us, baby, you need to be saved.
That's
baby,
right.
You need to kind of talk that time to get out of this mess and get saved.
Yeah.
And now they back in stuff they say God done delivered them from.
So true.
They saying stuff like the dreams to another. Some of them get cussing.
Yes.
Old demons done came back and start living them.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Thank you. My spirit was talking about the scripture this morning. Talking about how when we done cleaned ourselves up and allowed the Lord to come in and He give us a new life and then we don't occupy. We don't occupy. Here comes seven more demons.
Yeah. What?
Seven more devils.
Yeah.
So now you thought you couldn't get rid of Michael Jackson back then. Uh-huh. Now you done went out there and did some mess. Now it's hard to show enough to get that mess out your spirit. Now it's hard to get Luther Vandross out your mind. It's hard to get cussing out your spirit now. Because you done practiced that thing since you went back out there in the woods. And see, the devil is skillful when he start throwing stuff at you to do. Because he knew where if the Lord come in and deliver, you'll never touch it again. So he got to try to get your mind off course. He got to get your mind off course of what God wants you to do and make other things look appealing to us. And many of us, it's going to be like these very few. If we don't get it together. The time is getting short. Yes. And you know, it's just so bad. You know, Israel had a problem. God had to bless them with land and different things and just blessing him.
Oh, yes.
God was just blessing the people.